Alright, what's going on, guys? Welcome back to another episode of the Ultimate Iron Man Progress Series. This is episode 3. Today we're going to be focusing on the total skill level. So for the past day and a half, I kind of took a break from RuneScape a little bit. I played The Forest with my girlfriend, my brother, and one of my friends. And then I was doing some barrows throughout the day while I was just AFKing, fishing and stuff. I was doing it on my group Ironman. I ended up banging out 51 fishing and 51 cooking while I was AFK. So not too bad at all. Total level starting out at 575 this episode. We want to push this to 750 by the end of the episode. That would be absolutely huge because the goal for this episode is to end with a rune pouch in the inventory and ready to go. So excuse me. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna finish up these last two sharks and then go cook them, get some food, and then we're gonna go start questing. Before we do that though, we're gonna go do this beginner clue scroll. We gotta talk to a Charlie the Tramp in Varrock. So let me get these two done, get a little bit of food to take with me, then we're gonna go do it. I don't know exactly what quests I'm thinking about doing first, but we'll figure that out as we go. Is this probably too many lobsters? Absolutely. Do we care? Absolutely not. Hey, Charlie, let's see what we got to do here. What can I do for you? Really need an iron dagger. You know what? We're going to go do that. Got the bronze pickaxe. So I literally came here to get my iron ore. By the way, we have 5 chances to get an iron bar, so let's hope with 29 smithing we're good. But as I got to this mine, I said, what's up, big homie, because I normally say what's up to people when I see them. And the dude said hi, and I saw he was an Ultimate Iron Man. I was like, hey, another one. I'm working on progress vid number 3 at the moment, so happy to see another one of us. And bro asked me what the YouTube was, he'll sub. And told him my name, and he came and subbed. He told me good luck and everything like that. But Jade Ring, shout out to you, man, for real. Appreciate it. I already know I'm about to make this iron bar on the first try. Fuck. Yay, there it is. All right, let's make this iron dagger and get back to Charlie. All right, let's go. All right, here you go, Charlie. Here's your iron dagger. What do you need me to do now? Blow a raspberry at Aeris in her tent. Equip a gold ring and a gold necklace. Alright, and there's the 2 gold bars. And it's time to... I gotta go to my house. Oh, by the way, you, as an Ultimate Iron Man, if you didn't know, you can go down to the Varrock West Bank. And I don't know why I went in there. To the Varrock West Bank, and you can telegrab gold bars. That's like the biggest way that people get gold bars as an Ultimate Iron Man. All right, I'm gonna throw these on, and what is it, blue raspberry? What's going on, Yuri? All right, what's this one? Brian Portsmouth Battle Axe Shop. All right. Hey, what's going on, Brian? Well, ooh, there's the first cask of the account. Yeah, it's a beginner one. Rub that bald head for good luck, and... Alright, so we're just not going to talk about that. We're going to go ahead and do Plague City and Biohazard first. I want to get those two done so I can get my Arty Cape. The Arty Cape is, I mean, it's just going to be such a good item to have for the account. After those two, we are probably going to finish up the Arty Easies. I already have most of it done. I really just need to go out to the fishing trawler. I need to enter the combat training camp, and I need to identify a rusty sword. All right, I got everything I need. It's time to go knock out Plague City. All right, after I finish talking to Edmund, yep, there it is. Plague City completed. Now I recommend you go to the arena. She wants to thank you. Yeah, that's fine. We can go do that. 23 money though. Nice. So now we're gonna go ahead and do. Let me find it quick. Biohazard, and then from there we're gonna finish the Arty Easy Diaries. Alright, and after this conversation with King Lathis, this should be Biohazard completed. After this extremely long, there it is. I decided to stop and get 51 magic so that way I can teleport to Arty with the completion of Plague City. Now I'm able to teleport here. Alright, first fishing trawler. Can we get a 1kc item piece? Well, I was gonna do this to see if I could get an angler piece, but I guess I got the sword, the 1kc, so I guess that ends fishing trawler for now. Totally forgot that the last two things I needed to do was go on the fishing trawler and identify this sword. So that's the already easy's done. Like, I guess elephant in the room, I'm sure you guys can tell, the whole client looks a little different. That's because last night, before I went to bed, after that last clip, I probably spent like an hour going through all of my rune light settings and just changing everything I could to make it look like this. And I'm really happy I decided to do that, and I'm really happy I decided to finally bite the bullet and spend the time to change everything, just so that way the quality of the videos improves a lot. So I'm sure this looks a lot better for you guys now, and I really, really hope it does. And I hope it'll all just bring more, I guess, enjoyment watching the videos now that it doesn't look just extremely big all over the place, and I have a tiny little inventory down here and a tiny little chat box down here. So I just hope overall it just looks a lot cleaner and a lot better for you guys. Alright, so as you can probably see by my inventory, I just went ahead and did Black Knight's Fortress. I don't get anything from it. The only reason I did do this quest is so that way I can now go do Recruitment Drive, which gives me 1,000 Herb Lore XP, which will put me well over 10 Herb Lore. So then that way I can do the Dig Site quest, which will give me another 2,000 Herb Lore experience. I just kind of want to chip away at getting 30 Herb Lore as fast as I can so I can use this lamp and fill up an inventory slot. The only thing I'm wondering is, for Recruitment Drive, if I remember correctly, I have to like clear my inventory so I can't have anything on me when I go in, which means I'm gonna have to suicide for the first time on the account. So I'll probably go store my Graceful if that's the case. Now the only thing is, I'm not 100% sure if that will destroy this antique lamp. If I do destroy, yeah, I cannot reclaim it, so I'm not 100% sure. I'm going to have to look into that. All right, so while I bank all my Graceful, I'm going to talk about this. I have done a bunch of research since the last clip, and it turns out that the only lamps that will not be kept on death, like the only ones that won't drop when I suicide, is ones that I can bank. And Achievement Diary lamps can't be banked. They have to stay in your inventory until they use, or you have to destroy them. So we're at a bit of a crossroads here because I need to do Recruitment Drive for two reasons. One, it'll give me 1,000 Herb Lore XP, and it'll allow me to do Dig Site quest and get 2,000 more Herb Lore XP. As well as I earn the ability to respawn in Falador, which makes suiciding a lot easier because I can suicide to the White Knights here, and then I will spawn literally right here next to where all my items are. So that'll be easy pickups whenever I have a looting bag and I get to the point where I have my looting bag, a full inventory, and I want to store stuff. So that'll help out a lot. So I think I just need to bite the bullet, and I'm going to go ahead and use this on prayer. The reason I'm going to use it on prayer is because I was level 30 exactly. I was only 400 XP away from 31. And it looks like it got me 32 prayer, which is not bad at all. And 1,100 XP away from 33. I feel like that was the best way I could have used this XP lamp, since I couldn't use it on Herb Lore. And that's completely my fault because I didn't look into it enough and remember that I needed a level 30 skill to be able to put it into. All right. And the first suicide on the account is completed. So if I'm not mistaken, I have about an hour until I can get my stuff back, so I can easily complete this quest way before that hour is up. So we're gonna go ahead and teleport to Soul Wars, exit out of Edgeville, and then run down to Falador and complete this Recruitment Drive quest. And coming over here, perfect, all of my items are on the ground, so I have about an hour. I think it took me like 3 minutes to walk here, so I'm gonna go ahead and knock this quest out and come pick up my items, and then we're off to do Dig Site quest after Recruitment Drive. Alright, and there's recruitment drive completed. That gives us 13 herb lore from 8. Now, oh, I actually get initiate helmet too. That's not too bad. Alright, let's get back over here, pick up our items, which, yes, they are still there. Perfect. And now we're gonna go ahead and do the dig site quest.
I'm a fucking genius. I'm too good. I'm literally too good. I'm putting the examiner and the whole dig site area out of a job. I run this bitch now. Oh my god, thank god, dude. I had to sift through this tray 65 times to get this charcoal.
Hey, out of this chat dialogue, there it is, dig site completed. I forgot it gave that much mining XP. Alright, so we got from 29 to 34, or what was it? I don't remember exactly what it was, but it was... And then we got from, I think it was 12 or 13 herb lore to 18 herb lore. So, very good quest knock out of the way. These two gold bars, I think I'm just going to go make into some sort of gold item and sell it. I got these through a random event, the pinball random event, when I was in the middle of the quest. So, I'm going to go sell these as well after I go make... Why did I come here? I need to go here. After I make these bracelets, and then from there we'll figure out which quest exactly we are going to do next. Alright, so I decided to go ahead and do Merlin's Crystal quest, so that way I can do the Holy Grail afterwards. That's another one of the Entrana quests that are good to knock out early. I don't have too much in my inventory, too many untradables and stuff like that. Actually, no untradables. I'm able to go to Entrana with ease, so I want to knock out as many of those as I can. Plus, Holy Grail gives like 15,000 defense XP or something like that, so that'll push my defense level up a lot without having to do like a lot of early like training XP and stuff like that. All right, after this chat dialogue, there's Merlin's Crystal done. We're going to go ahead and do Holy Grail now. Just got absolutely ran through. But yeah, this is also the beauty of the suiciding in Falador. So, the reason I suicide is I have to go to Entrana. So, I'm going to leave all my stuff there. I have a 55-minute timer. It shouldn't take me even close to 55 minutes to get through the Entrana portion of this. I think I just have to go there and talk to the High Priest. And then from there, I can get back out, get my stuff, and then continue on with the quest. So, we're going to go do that. Oh my god, bro, finally. That literally, like, I'm not even bullshitting you. I logged in when I got here, because I logged out because I had to go, I'm not gonna lie, I had to take a shit. And I logged back in here, and then I forgot what I needed to do. I needed to go do something, though, and when I came back, this was at like 10 minutes. It took me 25 minutes to flinch him with the lava battle staff and get the final hit on the Excalibur. Bro had 7 HP for like 15 minutes. I'm not going to lie to you. Oh, but it's finally done. Jesus Christ. Okay, now we can finish up Holy Grail. Oh my God, King Arthur here. Jesus Christ. That quest, not a hard quest. That Black Knight Titan is what took like... The 30 minutes out of like the 40 minutes in total it took me to do that quest. 35 minutes of that was trying to kill that Black Knight Titan. But nevertheless, Holy Grail completed. Let's see what we got. I think I was 33 prayer, so I got 37 prayer, as well as from 11 to 32 defense. That is absolutely massive. 633 total level, so I need about 117 more levels, and then we can go for the rune pouch. So we are steady making very, very good progress here. All right, while I was AFKing fishing, I got an easy clue scroll, so we're gonna go ahead and see if we can complete it. All right, search this crate. Second step, search drawer, shop of unit. Okay, we can do that one too. All right, what's a Leon? Let's go ahead and open these drawers. Search drawers. All right, cool. There's an easy casket. We're not even going to waste any time. We're just going to open it. All these trees in the way. Whatever. Here we go. Yep, just about what I expected.
Alright, so there's a couple quests that I wanted to go ahead and do. I want to do Nature Spirit, but I need to get, I think it's 18 crafting to make a Silver Sickle. So I'm going to do that quest, and then I want to do Jungle Potion and Shiloh Village. And there it is, 750 crafting XP. That's really all I cared about as of right now. Dwarf Multicannon, I won't have one of those for like literally ever. So 9 to 12 crafting. Let's go ahead and do... What did I say I was going to do? Update. It was Observatory Quest is what I was going to go do. Because that's going to give me like 2.2k crafting experience, which should put me to 18 crafting so I can go ahead and do Nature Spirit. Alright. I guess I probably got like the best one I could have... what's it called? Observed. I got the Libra one, I guess, which gave me Law Runes. I don't remember how many I had before this. But he told me it rewarded me with some Law Runes, so that's what's up. But that got us 13 to 19 crafting. Which means we can make the Silver Sickle, and we can go do Nature Spirit. Alright, and after he transforms his little grotto or whatever, there it is, Nature Spirit completed. 3k crafting experience. I should get a defense and a hit points level as well. But yeah, there's 24 crafting, so from 20 to 24... There's a defense level, and I thought I would get a hit points level. I guess not. So now we're going to go ahead and do Jungle Potion, and then we're going to do Shiloh Village. All right, and this should be Jungle Potion completed, which actually means we're going to get from 18 to 20 Herb Lore. All right, there's that shit-ass quest completed. I really hate this quest, but Shiloh Village completed. 3.8k crafting XP gets to 28 crafting. I'm probably never going to craft a hard leather armor body in my life. All right, I wanted to go ahead and do Varag Museum just because it's an easy 18 total level. So there's 9 Slayer and 9 Hunter, which is a 686 total level. Yeah. I have no idea what quest I'm about to go do now, but, yeah, I don't know. We'll figure it out. Yeah, I totally forgot I could come up here and tell this guy the stuff about the quest and stuff like that. So there's 2,000 Herb Lore XP. That's 20 to 22 and from 22 to 23. All right, I want to do Lost City, but I didn't have the crafting level to do it. There's Elemental Workshop 1, that should give me, yeah, so I can go do Lost City now, but while I'm here, I might as well do the second Elemental Workshop and knock that out of the way. Alright, and that's Elemental Workshop 2 done. So, with that being done, I guess it's 36 smithing and 35 crafting. So now I'm going to do Lost City and Fairytale Part 1. But also, I wanted to say, while I am like not recording and away from my keyboard, I'm working towards Barbarian Fishing. I need one more fishing level, and then I can go do Barb Fishing. Well, I was able to do Barb Fishing at 48, but I got told to wait till 58, so that way I can catch Leaping Salmon as well. So it's just more XP per hour. Oh, I didn't record me opening it, but I got... the fucking first piece, finally. I'm doing this. I'm taking a break from questing. I'm going to get the full angler outfit because I figured I have like 33,000 feathers. I figured if I'm going to be like AFKing barbarian fishing and stuff like that while I'm like not on my computer and stuff, I might as well just get the full angler outfit and make the most out of it.
22 fishing trawlers since the last piece.
All right, I'm not going to lie. I've done like I whenever I got this piece, I logged out and logged back in, so this reset, so I've done 33 since this top. I'm tired of sitting in this chair, so I'm gonna do the rest on my phone while I lay down. Oh my god. Okay, so this clip is gonna kind of be all over the place. I've killed 48 thugs, like staff bashing them for a looting bag, so I finally got a looting bag. I was gonna barb fish, so I wanted the two tick barb fish. That's why I was getting Guam leafs. I ended up killing like 88 men according to the loot tracker, and just got a bunch of herbs so that way I can store some in the looting pouch because I want to start stacking up a bunch of herbs. Another thing, I finally got the full angler outfit. So that was ass to do, but we finally got that. While I was killing these thugs, I got an easy clue scroll.
So yeah, that's pretty much like where to get everybody up to speed. Like 61 fishing. When I tell you fishing trawler, I was dry. I got these three about halfway through 59 fishing. It took me halfway through 59 fishing to 61 fishing to get the angler hat. It took me so long. It was ridiculous. All right, we're going to go ahead and knock out this clue scroll, and then we're going to... I can actually use this. And then we're going to go to Lost City. All right, let's go ahead and search this bookcase. Give me this. Search the crate in a building in Henmite. Where even is that? Ranging Guild? All right, step number two. What do we get? It is Falador Shield Shop. All right, and step number three, Amir's Arena is your next destination. All right, we got the casket anyway. All right, since you guys are fighting, I'm going to go ahead and open this here. Hey, I don't even know what I'm going to use those for. So I just realized I literally wasted like 20 minutes trying to get a rune pouch, or not a rune pouch, a looting bag from, what's it called? The thing, the thugs. I have to do the Entrana step, so I literally have to suicide here anyway. So my looting bag is just gonna get destroyed as it is. So I'm gonna have to go get another one of these, which kind of sucks. But I mean, I guess that's fine. I'm not even gonna lie, yo. First kill, and I got the bronze axe. Oh, that's so nice. All right, let's go ahead and kill this thing, get off Entrana, and get our stuff back. Oh, I don't have run energy though. This is gonna hurt. Oh no. Alright, yeah, we're good. I'm not even gonna lie, yo. First kill, and I got the bronze axe. Oh, that's so nice. Alright, let's go ahead and kill this thing and get off Entrana. Oh, I'm so excited to see this place on the Ultimate Iron Man for the first time. There it is. Yes, sir. Alright, 3 quest points, access to Xanaris. Now we're going to go do Fairytale Part 1. Oh, that was so much easier. I only had to kill 2 thugs for this one. Yeah. Actually, we'll take this Guam Leaf too, because we need Herblore XP. Yeah, so I know I said I was going to go to Fairytale Part 1, but then I totally remembered Tanglefoot. The way you heard him is based off of your farming XP and or level, and mine is 1. So we're going to plow some Hosidius fields until I get probably like 5 farming or something like that. All right, we're at the point of the quest where it's the moment of truth. How is RuneScape gonna fuck my ultimate Iron Man today? Where you at? A slimy eel, a bunch of grapes, and an uncut ruby. The grapes will be easy, for sure. I just gotta get a thing of grapes. An uncut ruby, I believe I can buy from somewhere. A slimy eel, I'm pretty sure I just fished that, but I'm kind of worried because I think I can only fish that in Mauritania, maybe. Yeah, okay, so I can fish that here. That's no big deal. I can do that. So we'll be back with all of the items. All right. So I'm not gonna lie, again, this uncut ruby was ridiculously annoying. So I was kind of forced to just get 40 mining, and now that I got 40 mining, I wanted to go mine gem rocks. Now, if I can find it, oh, there it is. There's a grape spawn right here, and then I have the fishing rod and the fishing bait to grab the slimy eel. I'm going to get that one last just because it is the fishing spot. I can get it from in here on my way to here anyway, so... We'll go ahead and grab these grapes. I'm going to go fish this eel, and then we're going to go enchant the secateurs. All right, and there's a raw slimy eel. So, damn, there's a raw slimy eel, so now we're going to go ahead and enchant these. I knew it was a good idea to get the 3 farming. I didn't miss a single hit while I was flinching the tangled foot. Even though I was only hitting 2s each time, I didn't, like, every single time that I went to hit it, I didn't miss. So it was pretty quick, I'm not going to lie. But there's Fairytale Part 1 completed. I don't think I'll get a level for anything except farming, but yeah, 18 farming, that's pretty dope. The biggest thing I'm excited for is to start the Fairytale Part 2, so that way I can, I can use fairy rings. So we're going to go ahead and start that. So that way we can get fairy rings unlocked. All right. And when now fairy rings are completely available to me now. Only one thing to do in a situation like this as soon as we get these unlocked. Yeah. We are home. I mean, come on. You know? Yeah. Alright, this should be the end of the quest. I don't know why I forgot you had to go to the altar, but this should be, what the hell? This should be Client of Karen done. And any second now, there it is. Go ahead and put both of these on Herblore. And quick 1,000 XP for Herblore. I guess it's to 25. Not bad. Alright, we're 12 levels away. Alright, I wanted to do Enter the Abyss. It's a quick 1,000 runecrafting XP. And there's 9 rune crafting. We are 4 levels away. Honestly, I'll probably just go get 4 fire making levels. All right, that took literally no time at all. Let's go ahead and light this last log, and we will hit 750 total. We can go ahead and go get the rune pouch. So here's the montage and all of the clips leading up to purchasing the rune pouch.
guys, and that's the end of the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. I'm super excited. We got a bunch done this episode. We got our rune pouch. We got the angler outfit. We also unlocked fairy rings, which is amazing for teleports around the game. But also, it's great that the Peng can finally revisit his island of all the penguins again. This was actually, this island right here was literally the inspiration behind the name of this account. But that's what we got done this episode. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Seriously, if you guys have been around since episode one, thank you guys for the continued support. I'm hoping that in your guys' eyes that these videos are getting better commentary wise and just clip wise and everything like that. If this is your first time viewing one of the videos, go back and make sure you watch episode one and two before you come here, so that way you're all caught up to speed with the Peng and his adventures. So we got 750 total this episode. We really want to shoot for 30 herb lore, so that way we can do more achievement diaries, as well as we can do one small favor to get us the lamps that can be used in herb lore, because it has to be level 30. And we got 18 farming. I know farming is like a big thing for Ultimate Iron Man, for herbs and stuff like that, and secondaries. I really want to figure out like the key to doing it, like how to do it, but I'm sure I'll figure that out soon. I'm gonna go ahead and edit this video and probably just AFK barb fishing. I still have 31,000 feathers I need to use to get to 82 fishing. So yeah, once again, I really hope you guys enjoy. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, tell me in the comment section what your favorite part of this video was. I'm excited to see what your guys' favorite parts was. But with that being said, guys, I'm out, and thank you all for watching.